Hi, good afternoon. It's Simon at Vans today in Worcester. I'm going to give you a quick video walk around of this 2018 on an 18 plate. It is the Citroen Berlingo 1.6 HDI Enterprise. So top of the range specification. It is a Euro 6 van as well. So if you're looking at London, ULEZ, Birmingham, Bath, Bristol, Manchester, all of that malarkey, all good for the emission zones. It's a one keeper from new van. It has covered 51,000 miles. In the silver metallic, and it's in great all-round condition, I have to say. The purpose of these videos is to give you a warts and all video walk around of the van, so a lot of our customers will watch these videos and actually purchase the van off the video, order it up, and either come and collect it or get it delivered. So let's get started. Nothing too much to point out to you. Obviously it's got a set of roof bars on it at the moment. Have a look at the roof, can't really see any damage up there. You've got a better view point of it than I, but if you don't want the roof bars, we can remove those for you. They are Rhino bars, so there's about 80 or 90 quid's worth of value there. Windscreen's all looking good. There are no major stone chips, cracks or anything like that that's going to cause either of us any grief when it comes to MOT time. Coming down to your bonnet, the bonnet is also in good all-round condition, no major stone chipping, all very neat and tidy. Coming to the front of the vehicle, the front end of the vehicle, your front grills, number plates, etc. All in pretty good condition. There's a couple of minor marks I'm going to show you, okay? So it's just where you got a little bit of a mark there, a little bit of a mark there, and I don't know, we might be able to do something with that with a magic sponge, we'll see. I suppose maybe a little indentation there. I think they've just pushed it up against something, maybe parking it in the garage or something, but... So a couple of minor marks there. Your passenger side headlamp unit, that's all good. Coming down to your front bumper corner on the passenger side, that is in good all-round condition with no scuffing. And if we have a look down the passenger side of the vehicle from this angle, again, there are no major dents or dings to point out to you, all looking pretty sweet. Round to the driver's side headlamp unit, that's all good. And then driver's side front bumper corner, again, all in good condition with no scuffing. Again, looking down the driver's side of the vehicle from this angle, again, nothing too much to point out to you. If anything, from a condition point of view, all looking pretty good. Passenger front wing, all looking pretty neat and tidy. I guess if we're being really, really fussy, is there the mildest of little dings in the wing there? Hasn't broken the paint, there's no mark there. There is something there, but nothing major. So your side repeater is present and correct. The wing as a whole, as you can see if I stand back, is in good order. Your driver's side steel wheel has a factory hubcap fitted to it. You have a Kleber tyre fitted to it as well. There is some minor scuff marks on your hubcap, but nothing major. And your tyre itself, that's all looking pretty good. Mirror unit driver's side is in good condition, as is the mirror itself, and your door glass on the driver's side, again, very good condition, no marks from it going up and down. Driver's side door is an overview you can see there. Everything lines up to the front wing and to the rear quarter as you would expect. No damage on there really to point out to you. It's all certainly nothing to stand out on it. Your driver's side door lock and handle's in good order. Even behind the handle, there's minimal scratching. And then just looking at your door edges, there's no major damage, chips, etc. to your door edges. White mark here is just polished, so that's just come off, happy days. And then looking at your sills lower down, all in good condition, all looking pretty good. Your black protective strip going down the side of the van is in overall good condition. If I'm being really fussy, you've got a little minor mark there, but apart from that, all looking good. Driver's side, rear quarter and arch, all neat and tidy. Driver's side rear steel wheel has a factory hubcap fitted to it and a Continental tyre. And your tyre tread depth is, as you can see there, it's all looking pretty good from that point of view. And then just looking down the side profile of the vehicle from this angle, again, just giving you another viewpoint of it. Really nice condition. Driver's side rear bumper corner in good condition. I think that's just where they missed a little bit of dressing on the bumper there. Your rear light unit this side, that's all in good order. And then coming round to the rear of the vehicle, we have the 60-40 split on the barn doors. Those are in good condition. The alignment of the doors all aligns nicely. We have obviously roof bars, as we've already pointed out. High level brake lights, all good. Alignment of the door and your door edges. Just follow it down, you can see. Nice condition. Door handle and lock is in good order. Rear bumper, we have a what looks like a little bit of impact damage there. But the bumper on the whole, as you can see, have a look at the top of the bumper. It's not shredded to pieces from people abusing it, getting stuff in and out. And you do have reverse parking sensors on the back of it. Inside the van, it's actually very tidy. Now, you do have an additional ply bulkhead fitted to it. Obviously, you can take that out if you want to. And then you'll be able to utilise the fact that your front seats fold down and give you additional load length, although you've still got that using that hatch there anyway. Ply lining on the floor, again, is in good overall condition as well. And it's nicely ply lined on the sides. And here's how you kind of see how much of a van has been used and abused. So your paintwork on the edges here, okay? Going up here, coming across here, and then going up here. Have a look. All very tidy condition. Whilst there are minor marks, there's no abuse. And then the other thing on a Berlingo, have a look at your rear doors. Inside of the rear doors, ply lined. These panels here, they're made out of papier-mâché. Normally those are holed and battered, but as you can see in this one, all very tidy. It's all nice to see. Coming to the passenger side of the van. Again, I'll give you an overview of the van looking down the side of it. Again, really tidy condition. Rear light unit this side, very tidy. Bumper corner this side, obviously there's that little impact thing that I've mentioned, but no major scuffing. And then moving to your upper quarter here, that's all good. Your sliding door rail, as you can see, that is also in good condition. We have your fuel and AdBlue filler here. We have the most smallest of little scratches here in the paintwork, okay? Do you an overview of the lower part of that arch, and you can see it's not a major drama, is it? We have some scuffing on the edges of your hubcap, which is a genuine item. We have a Continental tire on that side. That tire has that level of tire tread. I'm not massively happy with how that's worn. I know we've got to replace the passenger front tire. We may well just review that and bang a couple of tyres on it at the same time, put them on the same axle. Happy days, isn't it? A sliding door this side, that's all looking good. We have what we've got here, maybe a little bit of a mark there on the sliding door. Nothing major, I think that's polish there. Polish left over from the Valeta. And we have that's a bit of polish left over from the Valeta as well. So overall, not too bad at all. Looking at your sills again, all good, no signs of any major damage. And then your protective strips down this side are all good. Passenger door itself, there's your overview of it. Your door glass, your door handles again, good condition, locks are in good order. And then your door edges on this side as well. Everything aligns up nicely and there's no damage to them either. Mirror unit this side, front and back, and the mirror itself's all good. And then passenger front wing, there's a little bit of a mark on this passenger front wing. I shall point it out to you. There's your overview of it. Can you see it? So we have here, looks like something's flicked up and hit it at some point. So don't know, we'll have to see. Might be able to smart repair that. We might not be able to, but we'll see what we can do. Your tire on this side, scrap. It's not scrap, it would actually pass an MOT. However, it's not going out with our name on it, so we'll replace that. And your passenger hubcap there, again, minor scuffing on it, but nothing major. Looking into the back of the vehicle from this angle, as you can see, your sliding door opens and slides back nicely. And then your sliding door shut, as you can see, very clean and tidy, as are your entry points on this side. Again, very clean and tidy. Ply lining in the back, all good. Just another viewpoint of the inside of the van from this angle. Onto the roof, back down again. Passenger doors, your passenger door card, black plastic. They can scratch up and get battered quite easily, but this one is in nice condition. Door shuts again, clean and tidy. Door seals on this side, all good. Have a look at your carpet. We'll move the paper mat out of the way. Carpet, as you can see, very nice and clean. Push that in there. Bonnet pull is just there. Glove box in there. Dashboard fascia is in good order. I've seen these really scratched badly and stuff, but no, this one's all nice. And then your headlining, as you can see, all good. We'll move our price board out of the way, show you the seats. And the seats are also in very nice, clean, tidy condition. Have a quick look under the bonnet. I'll try and do this one-handed. So, under the bonnet, as you can see, what am I going to say? It's very clean and tidy. Door wing bolts, etc. All the original paintwork on there. There's your coolant. It is the correct colour coolant for Citroen. There's no contamination in there. All good. Dipstick, oil filler, brake fluid, and battery fuse box. Have an overview. These things, we sell loads of Berlingos and Peugeot Partners. Obviously, they're the same van. I'm a massive believer in them. I get very little issues with them. I've sold them to people that will bang 300,000 miles on them, no problem at all. Cheaper than a Connect, more reliable than a Connect, far, far cheaper than a Caddy, obviously. So, well, you pay your money, take your choice, but these are pretty good. Door, card, driver's side, all good. Door shuts, driver's side, all good. Entry seals, driver's side, that's all good as well. Carpet flooring this side, that's all good. Pedal rubbers are good, there's no excessive wear. Driver's seat, bolster, etc., all good as well. Steering wheel this side, as you can see, still has the factory finish on it. We have electric mirrors down here, headlamp levelers to the left of that. Then we have your interior alarm sensor off, your parking sensor off, and your electronic stability program button off there. Vents are all good. That's your holder for your additional sat-nav that you have to pay for. Don't have the additional sat-nav. They're utter shite, to be quite frank with you, unless it's in here. But everybody just uses their telephone, because obviously this thing has Apple CarPlay and Mirrorlink. Top of the dash, as you can see, is all good. Dashboard itself, fire it up. So we've just gone 100 miles over on the service interval, so we will get it serviced before it goes out. When I say we get it serviced, it doesn't just have an oil and filter change and wipe its arse. It has a oil and filter, air filter, pollen filter, fuel filter, wheels off brakes check as well, so you'll know exactly what your brake pads have got left on it. You'll know exactly what tyre tread depth you've got left on the vehicle. And we do 110 point PDI check and an electronic health check, linking it up to our diagnostics to make sure there's nothing hidden in the background. Air conditioning, blower fans, etc. here. Menu button here. So this will run you through. You've got DAB, FM and AM. As I say, settings, back to other screen. Calculator, yeah, all of that stuff there. Where are we? Telephones, not the telephone button. So you've got Bluetooth telephone and Bluetooth music. There we go, that's the screen I'm after. Apple CarPlay and Mirrorlink. Okay, you've got a USB point just down here. So use that with the lead of your telephone and then it will mirror your telephone to the screen and you can use Google Maps for navigation or Waze or whatever you use on your telephone. The air conditioning, that's all coming out really nice and cold. Obviously it's baking at the moment, isn't it? So that's nice. Electric mirrors, 12 volt power, central locking for the back, central locking for the whole vehicle. Hazard warning lights, electric window for the driver's side. 5-speed manual gearbox, reverse gear to the right and back, and that will activate your parking sensors. This is all in nice order as well, as is your gear knob. Left-hand stalk here, turn it, side lights, main lights, indicators are up and down on it. There is your cruise control and speed limiter. And then on this side, we have your wipers. Button on the end there runs you through your computer system on the dashboard. And then the lower one there is for your volume search controls for your stereo as well. So they're a really nice specification van as well. And that's about it, really. There are 60 to 70 photos of this van on my website. My website is vanstoday.com. We are Vans Today Worcester, based in the centre of the country, offering you nationwide delivery, part exchange and finance. Feel free to call us on 01905 672 080 or email us sales@vanstoday.com. If you're worried about who you're buying off, check out our reputation online. We have reviews on Google, got them on Facebook, we're on Instagram and LinkedIn as well. And that's about it. Thanks for looking at the video. 15 minutes of your life you're never going to get back, but if you are interested in this van, it will give you a very good, honest description of what she's like. Cheers.